Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel, and today is going to be a rather different content because it's not beauty, it's not fashion, it's a little bit of lifestyle, but it's mostly tech. Okay, so today I'm going to be talking to you guys about a smartphone gimbal. This one is the Moza Mini S, okay? Now, why would you need a smartphone gimbal? If you're like me who likes to use their phone to do vlogs and are sick and tired of all the shaky content or having to have somebody else film you while you're vlogging, then this would be something that is good to have. Now, this is $99 here in Australia. I believe in the US it's $79, which is pretty darn affordable for what it is. Gimbals usually range from $100 US up or about $140 here in Australia. I was actually contemplating between this and the DJI Osmo Mobile 3 gimbal, which is another, probably one of the best ones. With the only difference is that, well, at least to me, the only difference is that the DJI Osmo talks to or is able to communicate with the Filmic Pro app. But if you're not that interested in that, I think you're okay with having the Moza gimbal. Okay, let's start with the unboxing first. Okay, so we're gonna start off by unboxing this Moza Mini S, and then I am going to tell you why I chose this over all the other gimbals out there. So, I got it off of JB Hi-Fi for $99 here in Sydney, and you can see it's all sealed up, so I'm gonna go and take my trusty shears and cut that here. And here. Okay, so that should open the plastic. It's always so satisfying to do this unboxing things when you're unsealing the item for the first time. Okay, so here we go. So white box. There's still another seal here, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. And then there's a little like ribbon here that you pull, and out comes your product. So first things first, you got your paperwork. So this, I believe, is the user manual. It says so on there, user manual. And then this is a getting started item. There we go. And then a sticker. I never actually asked, but where is Moza from? Is it a Japanese company? WeChat. Oh, it's probably Chinese then. Yeah. Okay. There we go. Does it say anywhere? Invented for video. Yeah, it's from Shenzhen, China. It says so here at the back. Okay, and then you got your silica gels to keep the humidity away. You have here your pouch that is still rolled in a black rubber band, which will come handy for when you take this into your bag. You don't want it to get scratched, but you also don't want it to scratch anything else in your bag. So nice velvety feeling pouch. You got a USB to USB-C connector. You also have this micro USB and a TRRS, I think it is, because it's got three lines, so I don't know what that would be for. Gotta read the manual. Then on here is one of the reasons why I chose this over the other gimbals, because this one already comes with a tripod leg. Although I could have bought the Osmo Mobile 3, I believe it is, and used my Joby tripod leg. Plastic, not that sturdy, but also not flimsy. So pretty good. Pretty good quality. Feels gonna be strong enough. And then of course you have the actual gimbal here. Okay, be careful not to break the motor before you even get it out. This is a little bit harder than I thought. Okay, here we go. So there it is, ladies and gents. Okay, and from what I understand, this is something that you can just here, there's a locking mechanism right there, so you can go ahead and then twist. Okay, so it's a twisting thing. Okay, and then it locks again once it gets to that perfect position. Okay, and that's how big the gimbal is. Now let's do this and put my phone in there. There we go, relatively centered. Does this have any charge in it? So since unboxing it, I have already plugged this in using the USB-C connector that it came with. So the power socket here, okay, that connects with the USB-C, and then the other side is just a regular USB. So what I did was I took out the cable of my iPhone charger and placed this on there and then charged it. Now it says on here on the user manual that it usually takes about 3 hours for it to completely charge. When you see it charging, there is a battery indicator here. So right there in the front, the battery indicator will tell you just how much battery is left. Now in the case when I got this out of the box, there was no charge whatsoever, so I had to charge it from zero, and it took about 2 hours. I took it off at 2 o'clock, and I've plugged it in at around 12 noonish. Yeah, so yeah, roughly about 2 hours. It didn't really take me 3 hours to completely charge it. Once it's completely charged, the red light will completely stop. It'll just be like nothing happened. And then when it's on, it's gonna turn blue and indicate that there is enough charge in your gimbal. So apparently one full charge is going to last 8 hours. At least that's what I've seen in most, if not all, of the reviews that I've seen about this. And 8 hours, okay, here it says specifications on page 6. So the maximum payload is 260 grams. So pretty much any smartphone, even with a case, would be within that 260 grams. My phone has got a case on it. This is the iPhone 11. The gimbal weight itself is 495 grams, or less than half a kilo. Okay, a little less. Extended dimensions is 116 cm by 95 by 31. That's with, what's the D? This can't be diameter. H is height. Okay, and then when folded, it's 130 by 68 by 195. Okay, now, it supports phones that are between 58 to 88 millimeters, so really it pretty much supports any phone. Battery life is 8 hours, charging time is 3 hours. Like I said, it didn't really take me 3 hours. Mechanical axis, angle, roll axis is 315 degrees. It doesn't rotate all the way to 360. That's fine. Not a lot of people will be using that inception mode anyway. Or is it the vertigo mode? I don't even know. The pan axis is at 270 degrees Celsius. Oh no, not Celsius. 200 angle. And the tilt axis is 200. Okay. Yeah, so let's see what this guy can do. So I told you guys earlier that this actually comes with its little tripod legs. Let me just get this out of the plastic. And that will connect to the screw at the very bottom. But, okay, when you see it, once you connect it and you open it up, it looks like it's in an angle, right? And I think that is simply because they need to center the center of gravity and make sure that it doesn't fall over. Now, the thing is, I also have here, because this is really tiny, I have yet to try it and see how well it works, but I also have here a Joby Flexipod, I think is what it's called, and I'm going to try and see if that's good. Oh, it fits. So if I wanted to extend the length of the gimbal, this is actually a pretty good length already, and then because this wraps pretty much with everything and everywhere, there's a lot of vlogging potential on here, okay? Right. So let's start off with putting on the phone. So as much as possible, let's first, there's a lever here, which I showed you earlier. Twist it like so, then lock it back in place. Now I'm going to put my phone on here and I'm gonna try and make it as center as possible, but yeah. Just as long as it doesn't hit any of the buttons on the sides, it's fine. And then now that I've got that sorted out, okay. Now that I've got this sorted out, let's turn this thing on. How do I do that? There's a power button here. And I think that's pretty much, I need to maybe move it a little bit. The great thing about this gimbal, which is unlike the other gimbals, is that your port, the bottom port of your phone, is actually accessible. Most of the gimbals that I have seen, including the DJI Gimbal 2, has got this motor here blocking your port here. So if you're intending to put on a microphone, you can't do that with the other gimbals, whereas this one, it is not blocking, so pretty good. Okay, now what do? Turn it on. You can see the blue light blinking. And there it is. It's just moved. Did you see that? I didn't see it. Let's do it again. So turn it off. And it just does whatever. And then when you turn it on, whoa, this is so cool. Now it can be a little bit obnoxious, especially if you're like me and you find it awkward to be vlogging in public, but I think this is going to really help me. So I could do that and it will stay focused on me. See? Up. Cool. I like that. Okay, now it comes with a joystick here, so you can pan the phone or the camera any which way you want with that joystick. There are buttons on here. One is like to record. One is to take a photo in the center. Am I reading this right? Is there like instructions on this thing? Yep, so there's the joystick. There are the operation buttons, so those are the ones. Charging port, battery level indicator, and the quarter inch port where you attach the legs. Okay, there is a focus button. Where's the focus button? It says there's a focus button at the back. You've got your telephoto and your wide angle here, and then you got you've got the trigger at the back. Now I have yet to, but I believe that the other this other cable here is meant for you to be able to control your phone, but if you're using an iPhone, what the fuck? Right? Okay, I'm gonna turn this off first, read a little bit more about the information that I have here in that pamphlet, and I'll get back to you. Alright, so you would have seen a little clip, and what I had actually done is taken that little cable with a TRRS plug on it, and I'm quite lucky because I kept my old iPhone 7's lightning adapter, So this is the lightning and the 3.5mm jack adapter that comes with a phone. And I kept it on there. And because I kept it, I was able to use it for the jack, which is able to then control what I do with the phone using the control buttons here. Okay, so let me just show you. This is the gimbal with a tripod leg on. And you can see here, it looks like it's gonna fall forward, but it won't. It's just so well balanced, and you can see what my camera is seeing, which is the background there at the back. Awesome. Okay, enough with the chit chat. I'm sure there's a lot of reviews that you can find here on YouTube to talk about the tech stuff. I am not a techie person, but I would like to test this out in real life. Okay, so as with anything in life, there is a learning curve that you need to go over with this particular gimbal. It's not the steepest learning curve I've ever had to overcome. There's a lot of trial and error. A lot of the times you would make a fool of yourself. But if you're like me and you're not an actual cinematographer and you're going to be using this gimbal solely for your day-to-day life, like for me for vlogging and for filming my OOTDs, then it does the job. It does the job wonderfully, if I might say so. As you can see, I'm gonna insert here the video of it following me around, because that's one of the things that I wanted to try out first with this, is the follow focus on this thing. So you would see a clip of me doing that. And now for the clip of this one being used as sort of like a selfie stick and really just like walking, going up the stairs to see how it stabilizes everything else. So it looks pretty cool. Does the job. We'll have to play around with it a little bit more, but so far so good. And for $99, where the rest are like exorbitant amounts, then this is really good. In fact, the other one that I mentioned I was looking at was the DJI Osmo Gimbal 3, but it was out of stock, and that was $159 for simply the gimbal itself. If you wanted to get the tripod leg, like this one that I have here, because there is a DJI combo kit that comes with this and a hard case, but that's $189 here in Australia, so almost twice the price of this gimbal, and this one already comes with the leg. Now the leg also has that like a sort of a rubberized bottom so that it doesn't slip. So that's pretty cool. And like I said, if you have one of these things, this could very easily fit in there as well. And you can place this gimbal pretty much anywhere that this will hold on to. Okay. Yeah, so that's basically the only reason why I chose this over the DJI. I haven't used any DJI products before. They're probably really good, because why would you be charging that amount of money if you can't prove that you are a good product. But yeah, I just didn't think that it justifies me buying that, especially since my use for this gimbal is simply for filming, vlogging, and my OOTDs. If you are looking at like doing like cinematic filming on your phones using a gimbal, then maybe you would consider the DJI Osmo Gimbal 3. But for me, I'm happy with this one. For the reason that I was also trying to get that DJI Gimbal Osmo is because it, like I said, communicates with the Filmic Pro, which is an app that I have on my phone. But the app, the Moza Genie, I think it's called, is not bad. Like I said, I have to play around with it a little bit more. Let me know in the comment section down below if you want me to film an update on that app and how I feel about it, whether it's clunky or if it works well enough. But bear in mind that I am not a tech reviewer. I am by no means one of those people who buy tech to review. This is me using it as how I intend to use it. And I'm just an everyday person, not a reviewer. So please be nice, okay? I think that's pretty much it. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you all again in my next lifestyle video. Bye.